So that question assumes some notion of randomness, but it's a very fuzzy concept to define. What I think is the most useful definition of randomness is the one that Andrei Kolmogorov came up with, which is based on Kolmogorov complexity. And this is an idea that was developed by the Russian Andrei Kolmogorov, as well as by the Argentinian Gregory Chaitlin. The idea is it's a way of measuring the complexity of some sequence, and it's defined as the length of the shortest possible description of that sequence. For this to be well-defined, we need to understand more precisely what a description is. One way to do this would be to say it's a Turing machine and decide on some formal way for writing down a Turing machine. But we could use any method of describing algorithms that we want. It could be a Python program. Whatever we select as our description language, Kolmogorov complexity is well-defined. And as long as that description language is powerful enough to describe any algorithm, it's a reasonable way to define complexity. And we can use that to define a notion of randomness. Some sequence is random if the shortest way to describe that sequence is the length of the sequence plus some constant. That means as we make the sequence longer, the description gets longer at the same rate. This matches the notion of randomness that we used informally in the quiz, that if there's a short program that can produce the sequence, that means it's not random. It has some structure to it, and the program shows us what that structure is. If there isn't any short program that can describe that sequence, well, that's an indication that the sequence is random, that there's no simpler way to understand that sequence other than to see the whole sequence. So this seems like a useful notion for understanding randomness. We're going to ask a quiz to see if it seems like a useful notion for measuring randomness. So the question is, for a given sequence S, is there a way to compute the Kolmogorov complexity of S? The choices are that we can, that it's the length of S plus some constant. So the second choice is, yes, we can. It's impractical to do this, but here's an algorithm for doing it. We can start by initializing n to 1. We can have a loop that keeps going until we find the correct value of n, which is the Kolmogorov complexity of the string S. And we're going to do that by looping through all the programs of length n. This is a big set, but it's finite. So in theory, that would eventually finish. And for each program, we're going to execute that program, see if it produces S as its output. If it does, that's the result that we want. And the third choice is no. It's theoretically impossible.